and reaffirmed by the seal of the university.
Please turn. I perform a most pleasant task on behalf of the university to congratulate you, very learned doctor, with the new degree.
Thank you very much.
Please be seated. I now give the floor to Professor Van Rijssen as supervisor for her laudatory address.
Dear Dr. Van Stam, dear Gert-Jan, it is truly a heartfelt pleasure to be able to congratulate you today on your achievement. And I'm not standing here on my own. I'm extending these congratulations on behalf of Professor Munirazi Mawere from the Great Zimbabwe University of Mazwingo and Professor Gerard van Oort-Messen. They have both played a pivotal role in guiding the work on your dissertation, and it has been a privilege to collaborate with two such wise scholars. They have tirelessly contributed to bring out the best of you. This was the work of a team. You also are not standing here alone. You are standing here representing the community of Macha, a community that gracefully received you and your family. In your thesis, you describe your struggle to enter this new community that would embrace you once you embrace the community. It is this embrace that came with new duties and obligations, new authorities to which you would submit yourself. Fred Meta is here to represent the community of Macha and as your leader. Fred has guided you with his authority and wisdom. You submitted yourself to it. Through submission to the authority of the community that received you, you became one with Macha. If we congratulate you today on your achievement, we congratulate the community of Macha, as your work represents their creative power, the Macha spirit of life and love, its understanding of Ubuntu, togetherness. Together, you undertook this journey. Together, with Janneke, Merel, Beauty, and Elmo, the big five, Van Stam family. Janneke, Merel, Beauty, and Elmo, we congratulate all of you. I can only begin to imagine how you have been part of this achievement. Whenever you were despairing for lack of connectivity, electricity, and all the other many challenges that needed to be overcome to finish this journey. It has been a journey of joint effort, resilience, sacrifice, love, and stubbornness. Today, you share in the pride of fulfilling this important work that will undoubtedly guide many. Gert-Jan, indeed, you did not come alone. We take immense pride at Tilburg University today that you, Dr. Van Stam, are accompanied by two chiefs. The Honorable Excellencies Chikanta and Charumbiro took the responsibility to personally bring you here to Tilburg University to allow you to fulfill your duty according to the tradition of the universities of the Netherlands. Your Excellency Senator, Chief of Chiefs, Mr. Charumbira, President of the National Council of Chiefs of Zimbabwe, and Your Royal Highness Chief Chikanta, former Vice Chairman of the House of Chiefs in Zambia, you represent a long tradition of authority, and your presence here today in the auditorium is a great honor to all of us. We are moved that you accompanied Dr. Van Stam to this moment, and we are grateful that you approved of his effort to try and understand the Macha community, undertake his work in Masvingo, and help us understand Africa through his eyes. We humbly request you, Honorable Chiefs, Honorable Chief, to send messages of well-wishing to your countries, Zimbabwe and Zambia. We are now connected as one family through this achievement, celebrated in this moment, and with our joint aspiration for a future in which Europe can learn from the African spirit of Ubuntu. And we thank you, Excellencies, for your care of the Van Stam family, and we humbly plea that you will take them back in your good care. Because it is not easy for us to let go of the Van Stam family. Many of us miss them because, as you can see, here in the Netherlands, they are also not alone. Even if Dr. Van Stam now has an African soul, he was born on this soil, and he still belongs to us here too. I would like to congratulate parents and parents-in-law and all your family here for this tremendous achievement, for which they will surely be proud. They have offered you, Gert-Jan, unconditionally, anxious at times for sure, when the going got tough, very tough, trying to understand why life had to be difficult, as it could also be easier. They kept on offering support. They embraced you, who you are, what you think is right, and, so it seems to me, the seeds of Ubuntu were sown early in your life. Thanks to the generosity of your parents, you could explore further and further, deeper and deeper, what Ubuntu can mean in this present-day world. I know how much you care for them and how grateful you are for their presence here today. Present here and in your life are many others, friends, many who do not want to be called by name. They have supported you, they have worried about you, they have admired you, and today they celebrate with you. You have a network of friends of every walk of life with an unprecedented loyalty, a loyalty you deserve, because in your generosity, you serve many to the best of your ability. This was a special journey. I remember when Gerard connected us for the first time through Skype, and we have never stopped talking. Over long distances, using any digital means, we were always in conversation. I learned a lot from you. You came to my house to check me out. In the forest, we talked. And then, like a marriage proposal, you asked me whether I would supervise your thesis. A thesis, you said, you would not deliver on paper, as the wisdom of Macha would only be delivered orally. And now today, here we have heard you speak. We've heard your reflections. Reflections that unite across boundaries and that force us to reflect on the quality of our globally connected society today, a society so difficult to understand. Let me then finalize with the words of the poet Jorge Luis Borges on two friends, Juan Lopez and John Ward. And I quote, "They lived in a strange age. The planet had been partitioned into different countries, each armed with loyalties, cherished memories, and an unquestionably heroic past, with laws, grievances, and their own peculiar mythologies, with bronze busts of great men, anniversaries, demagogues, and symbols. The division, the labor of cartographers, was good for starting wars. Lopez was born in the city by the motionless river, Ward. Ward, in the outskirts of the city, once walked by Father Brown. He had studied Spanish in order to read Don Quixote. The other professed a love of Conrad, who had been revealed to him in a classroom on Via Monte Avenue. They might have been friends, but they only saw each other once, face to face, somewhere down in those two famous islands, and each of them was Cain, each Abel. They were buried together, decayed in the snow. These events took place in an age we cannot understand. Dr. Van Stam, may I dare to say, Dr. Africa, thank you for shedding some light into our dark age that we find so difficult to understand. Thank you.
You will have more opportunity to congratulate him during a reception, but that will not be in this building, I understand, but, well, probably many of you know already and others should connect. The committee will withdraw, and the Dr. Van Stam as well, first to a room to the side here. Please stand up. I'll do the concluding prayer in Dutch. Mogen dankbaarheid ons volgen op onze zoektocht, barmhartigheid ons vergezellen en liefde ons voorgaan. The session is concluded.